Every who down in Whoville liked Christmas a lot, but the Grinch who lived just north of Whoville did not. The Grinch hated Christmas, the whole Christmas season. Now, please don't ask why. No one quite knows the reason. It could be that his head wasn't screwed on quite right. It could be, perhaps, that his shoes were too tight. But I think that the most likely reason of all may have been that his heart was two sizes too small.
And then he growled with his Grinch fingers nervously drumming, "I must find a way to keep Christmas from coming. Those who have been preparing, I know their ways. They don't just celebrate Christmas on that dreadful day. They prepare the whole season. They make popcorns and packages and bags. They string tinsel and make wreaths without high prices or tags. They make ornaments, homemade and painted. Ugh, how disgusting."
For tomorrow, he knew, all the Who girls and boys would wake up bright and early. They'd rush for their toys, and then, oh, the noise, oh, the noise. Then the Whos, young and old, would sit down to a feast, and they'd feast and they'd feast. They would start on Who pudding and finish with Who roast beast. And then they'd do something he liked least of all. Every Who down in Whoville, the tall and the small, would stand hand in hand and sing. And they'd sing, 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 sing. The more the Grinch thought, I must stop this whole thing. But how?
Then he got an idea. An awful idea. The Grinch got a wonderful, awful idea. "I know just what to do," the Grinch laughed in his throat. And he made a quick Santa Claus hat and a coat. "Now, all I need is a reindeer." The Grinch looked around. "If I can't find a reindeer, I'll make one instead." So, he called his dog Max.
Woof, woof, woof.
Then he took some red thread, and he tied a big horn on top of his head. Then he loaded some bags and some old empty sacks on a ramshackle sleigh, and he hitched up old Max. Then the Grinch said, "Giddy up."
And the sleigh started down towards the homes where the Whos lay a snooze in their town. He threw the stockings and the gifts up the chimney with glee. "And now," grinned the Grinch, "I'll stuff up the tree." But he turned around fast and he saw a small Who. Little Cindy Lou Drew, who was not more than two. The Grinch had been caught by this little Who, who'd got out of bed for a cup of cold water. He stared at the Grinch and said, "Santa Claus, why? Why are you taking our Christmas tree? Why?" "Why, my sweet little tot," the fake Santa Claus lied, "there's a light on this tree that won't light on one side. So I'm taking it home to my workshop, my dear." And his fib fooled the child, and he patted his head, and he got him a drink, and he sent him to bed.
3,000 feet up the side of Mount Crumpet, he rode to the tip-top to dump it. "Pooh-pooh to the Whos," he was grinchously humming. "They're finding out now that no Christmas is coming." And the Grinch put a hand to his ear, and he did hear a sound rising over the snow. But the sound wasn't sad. Why, this sound sounded merry.
Adore, adore, welcome Christmas, Christmas Day.
Every Who down in Whoville, the tall and the small, was singing. Without any presents at all. He hadn't stopped Christmas from coming. It came. Somehow or other, it came just the same. It came without ribbons. It came without tags. It came without packages, boxes, or bags. And he puzzled 3 hours till his puzzler was sore. Then the Grinch thought of something he hadn't before. Maybe Christmas, he thought, doesn't come from a store. Maybe Christmas, perhaps, means a little bit more. And what happened then? Well, in Whoville they say that the Grinch's small heart grew 3 sizes that day. And the minute his heart didn't feel quite so tight, he whizzed with his load through the bright morning light, and he brought back the toys and the food for the feast. And he, himself, the Grinch, carved the roast beast.
Man!